Hi, my name is Hana Hakami. I am PhD in cell biology. During my undergrad and graduate studies, I had been under high stress in an endless chain of complications, either in my personal or professional life. The higher I go through my grad school, the harder time and the high stress I was going through as well, especially when I was doing my PhD studies the past 7 years. However, there are hobbies that I have been practicing them through the time of continuing my education. Through grad and postgraduate studies, these hobbies have helped me so much to recover every time from a stressful episode I went through, or at least rescued my mental health from falling apart. I am addressing this topic here because I believe it's very important to maintain stress in a positive way, and practicing your favorite hobbies will save you through chronic stress, as it did for my case. Using this strategy really helped my brain to heal every time from a stressful event. Unfortunately, stress affects our ability to focus and work efficiently. Stress reduces the quality of our living and health. So we need to break stress cycle by every possible way. Yes, everyone is different. What I like and what I am interested in it are not necessarily to match yours. I am here to share my own experience with you about hobbies I love to practice or would like to gain as my hobby that came good to me, hoping to inspire you for your own favorite hobbies and build more or any if not existent. Before I go ahead with the hobbies I have been practicing, I would like to share with you the fact about all human beings are naturally enhanced to discover. Learning new things with love and excitement is the key toward enjoying the moment and enjoying what we do. Seeking to heal our wounds caused by a sad, stressful event happened to us through time. For this purpose, I would like to invite you to dedicate a time for yourself, just for your hobbies, to practice and enjoy them, to release a lot of stress. If you lost a hobby, just try to recover it slowly and gradually. Don't be harsh on yourself when you are already stressed. If you find yourself you have never really developed a hobby, then just discover yourself. Discover your area of interest out of your profession, and how you can develop a hobby out of your interests. By practicing this hobby, you will feel peace and going through an easy time that you forget about stress that you have been through. Create for yourself a list of hobbies that let you benefit from them and may benefit others as well. Here, when you practice your hobbies, yourself is the most important person in your life to know and to discover. So enjoy learning yourself and enjoy riding the moment, developing your skills in your favorite hobbies, or at least just have fun when you are practicing them. First hobby that has a tremendous positive impact on my life is my being insisting on learning more about things move and using different transportation methods. When I was a child, I had roller skating shoes and a bike. I was so good in both of them. After the age of 6 years old, I never had them again. Also, when I was a child, I was talking about that I'm going to learn how to drive a car, a truck, a train, and I would be a helicopter pilot when I grow up. I wanted to travel with bus and train across the country. I wanted dearly to sail on ship and cross the oceans. It was too much for some people around me. and it was just like a dream that cannot be true. But you know what? When I started my PhD, I got a second-hand bike. And guess what? I forgot how to bike. So I began practicing biking and learning by myself how to bike again, until I became a good biker and bike safely on the road in such a funny way, but determined. Since then, I have had so much fun biking, either alone, with friends and neighbors, as well as with my kids. 1 year after starting my PhD, I joined a small vehicle driving course. I learned driving a car from scratch. And now I'm not only licensed to drive a car, but also I am a motorcyclist. I have traveled with my children by our car and have fun with camping and other activities. And hopefully soon to enjoy riding my motorcycle for beautiful trips with my husband. I'm still going through the rest of this hobby list to learn more about things move. However, until I became able to drive a bus or be licensed to fly a helicopter as a pilot, I have already enjoyed some trips on bus and train. One of the most beautiful bus trips that I have made was going to Dallas, US from Montreal, Canada in a round trip in only 5 days in summer 2016. It was a crazy trip, but I enjoyed it so much and I learned a lot from it with so many adventures. The second hobby that has also a tremendous positive impact on my life is being in love with physical activities. I love biking. I love hiking and walking outdoor. I love to move my body and work out. I am obsessed with learning different gym machines and eager to learn how to use them and use them safely. I always want to be an active, sportive person. For long years, I wanted to learn yoga and be good in it. Among other sportive activities that I wanted to learn. And when the time came and I joined the yoga class, I failed. I found myself I couldn't enjoy it. I tried, but it didn't work with me. So I discovered and I learned myself yoga is not for me. Perhaps later, but not now. Yes, yoga wasn't for me. However, I found myself in swimming and in taekwondo. Also, I found myself in love with Pilates and with jump rope. I am not professional in any of these sportive activities, but I can do them and love them and enjoy the time I'm doing them. I love to spend my time and energy on these activities. The time I work out, I become tired, but I end up with having a very good day, a quality sleep at night, and a better and healthier eating habits. I love being active and work out. That makes me feel enlightened inside my soul. The third hobby is about discovering and learning different cultures and languages. It is so lovely to find yourself proud of your own culture and have a deep knowledge about it while having a better understanding of the other cultures in the world around you. The best when you learn different languages on the way. This hobby is as joyful as it has to be done respectfully and safely. For me, it results in unlimited joy and open my horizons wider. The fourth hobby is about planting and gardening. I love to seed to grow a plant, as I love also to transplant. The good thing that recently I have learned how to rescue almost dead plants. After experiencing multiple plants, I have died sadly in my home due to wrong care or just being neglected without my intention. I am so happy that I have rescued 6 plants during the past year, plus maintaining healthy other 5 plants. And I am trying to rescue 1 more plant while transplanting 3 more. I hope one day I have enough space to be able to grow my food and harvest my own fruits and vegetables. I am dreaming towards self-sufficiency. It is another big dream, and why not? The fifth hobby is about food. I love cooking and feeding people, especially feeding my lovely friends and family. Unfortunately, with COVID-19 pandemic, it is difficult to gather and making something to share it with others. But I'm still trying to put some time in recipes in the kitchen that I share their outcome with people I love and I care for them. The sixth hobby is about papers and colors. I love to draw and paint, as also I love to write and read. I haven't shared in public my writings and my artwork, but I started sharing my thoughts from my reads and my own life. And I hope I will share my work in writing and art making with you soon. The seventh hobby, I love home reorganizing and kitchen rearrangement. It is exhausting, but I really enjoy my time and easily get several hours, even going too late to bed, when I'm decorating my home and rearranging the locations of stuffs and furniture around multiple times a year. I am growing through this and trying to be very simple on designing and decorating my home. I found myself, I just love it, very simple and functional with a few details. I am learning myself and my needs every day more. Interestingly, every time I go through my home furniture and stuffs rearrangement, I become surprised about how different I became and how I have been adopting different concepts about living and keeping stuffs in my home every time I rearrange my home and redecorate it. Just changing the locations of my stuffs at home let me sense how I am still growing and let me know what I really exactly need and what I really want to keep and have in my future dream home, like the colors of the paints and the location of the window, the furniture that I will have, the type of the floor I would like to walk on, and the place where to garden my plants. I am very excited about how my study room will look like, etc., etc. Also, I love watching and learning indoor design and how to renovate homes. It's not only interesting, but makes me happy to discover new things and see things from different perspectives while I'm enjoying the process of rethinking and adapting new ideas about having a home design, decor, and furniture. These are my hobbies. I have practiced and I am still working on learning more and more hobbies. Tell me about yours in the comment section. We came to the end of this episode. Please give the video like, share it, participate in the comment section, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and please take care of yourself. Goodbye, and see you soon.